Even though Helix has fantastic routing capabilities and flexible dynamic control, it wouldn't matter if it didn't sound good. So in this video, we're going to go through three different examples, a clean, a semi-dirty, and a very dirty, and we're going to build them as we go, live, so you can see just how quickly you can dive into Helix and get fantastic results. We use two DSP processors inside Helix, and that means that we finally have the DSP overhead to be able to accurately describe a lot of idiosyncratic and sort of wrong things inside amps and vintage pedals. So in the HX amps, for instance, we went through circuit point by circuit point and matched from point to point. So from this stage of the circuit to this stage in the circuit, we made sure that our modeling matched before we moved on. So it's kind of like profiling from the inside out as opposed to the outside in. And it means that you get interactive knob behavior and all of that sag and gooiness that you expect. So what we're going to do now is take that HX modeling to the test and build three quick little sounds. So come over here. Joystick to go to the amp and cab menu, deluxe vibe, and that's going to be pretty loud for vibe, so I'm going to take it down here to clean it up a little bit. And in the studio, I always run everything through a pair of cabinets that are just in the closet mic'd up all the time, so I'm just going to do the same thing here. There we go. And now, that's it. Now, if you want to spruce that up somewhat, you can just add a reverb. Just tweak the mix. There you go. So you can see that it's really easy. One little tweak, two little tweaks, done. So let's move on to the semi-dirty sound. Okay, another blank preset, amp and speaker menu, and we're gonna go for the jumped plexi. There we go. Now I'm a ribbon guy, so I'm just gonna come over to the cabinet, move it to a 121, and bring the distance right up to the grill. Didn't even touch a knob. I'll use that every day, all day. Works just fine. If you want to grease it up, maybe add a delay. Simple, and just turn the mix down to 19 or something. Maybe do your typical 350 kind of 400-y, millisecond-y kind of delay sound, and there you go. Yeah, all day, every day. So let's move on to the next sound. All right, so this was a heavy one. So back to the amps and cabs. This time we'll get for the Panama guy. There you go. Maybe move the mic a little closer. Get a little bit more bottom and just turn the drive up a little bit. There you go. It's a great starting place. So from there you can change microphones, change speaker cabinets, tweak a knob, which we've not really done much of. I would suggest at first that you pick amps, speaker cabinets, and microphones that you're familiar with in the real world, so that you have a baseline of behavior, and then go from there. As you can see, getting great sounds in Helix is pretty much as fast as turning on the unit, plugging in, and picking your favorite amps to play around with. So thank you guys very much for your time. Check out all of the other videos in the series, and then find a certified Helix dealer near you and check one out. Thanks and cheers.